नमस्ते। आई लिव इन गोरखपुर फ्रॉम द फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक एमपी इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डायग्नोस्टिक एंड कम्युनिटी हेल्थ इन द डिसिप्लिन ऑफ कार्डियोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेशन दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर जनरल रेडिएशन सेकेंड एंड रेडियोग्राफिक टेक्निक ऑफ होल बॉडी फॉर डीसीआरटी सेकेंड इंस्ट्रूमेंट। आई एम फ्रॉम जयपुर विद्यापीठ रोमन यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। नमस्ते। टूरिस्ट टेक्निक जस्ट लेटरल डेक्यूबिटस व्यू। सो लेटरल डेक्यूबिटस व्यू ऑफ द चेस्ट इज स्पेशलाइज्ड प्रोजेक्शन रियली यूटिलाइज विद द कम्युनिटी ऑफ सीटी। इट इज चीफली यूज टू पीडियाट्रिक पॉपुलेशन। सो द व्यू लेटरल डेक्यूबिटस व्यू इज स्पेशलाइज्ड प्रोजेक्शन जो कि व्हिच इज रियली यूटिलाइज। ओके in some special cases. Okay. So, or just a lateral decubitus view is an important view for chest examination that is in radiographic technique of full body course. Okay. Indication undertaken to demonstrate small pleural effusion. So, it is used to demonstrate small pleural effusion or for the investigation of pneumothorax and air breathing due to inhaled foreign body. Okay, inhaled foreign body. So next the patient position. Patient position. In the patient position, the patient is lying either left lateral or right lateral on a trolley on top of the radiolucent sponge or pillow. Okay. When investigating pneumothorax, the site of interest should be up. Okay. When investigating pleural effusion, then the site of interest should be down. Okay. When we are going to check the fluid level, small fluid level, then the site that is in touch. That is in touch should be down, should be in the same side, incision side. Retractor splint landscape posterior to the patient running parallel with the long edge of the thorax. Okay, so the patient's hand should be raised to avoid superimposing on the region of interest, leg will flex fully. So, patient's hand should be raised to avoid superimposition. There should be no superimposition on the region of interest, leg will be flexed for balance in a lateral decubitus. Okay, rotation of shoulder or pelvis should be minimized. Okay, so there should not any rotation of shoulder or pelvis. Patient should be changed into a hospital gown with radiographic item removed like bag, zipper and any other metallic object that is present in the chest region. X-ray is taken in full inspiration. So ask to the patient to hold a breath in the inspiration. Okay. So the technical exposure factor. So this is the lateral decubitus view in the lateral position. The centering point, mid-sternal plane, mid sternum at the level of T7. Okay, collimation laterally to include both lungs. Okay, so the both lungs are covered in the collimation or in the field side. So superior to the apex. Okay, so above the apex. Okay, inferior to the costo diaphragmatic region. Okay. gasket should portray. Detector size that is used is 14 by 17 inches or in centimeter 35 by 43 centimeter. Exposure that is used in the rectimeter view is 60 to 70 kbp. Okay, and the MES used is in the range of 16 to 30. SID, source to image detector distance is 100 centimeter. Or next is a grid. Grid is used in this projection. Next is the image technical evaluation. A marker annotating horizontal beam diameters should always be present. So marker is should always be present with the side of interest clearly labeled. Okay, the marker is made by the marker that is made by the lead that is clearly labeled left or right. Okay, the entire lung field should be visible from the apices. Okay, down to the lateral CP angle, costophrenic angle. The chain should not be superimposing any structure. Okay, any structure, minimal to no superimposition of the scapula border on the lung field. Okay, next is the sternoclavicular joints are equal or equidistant apart. Okay, the clavicle is in the same horizontal plane. A minimum of 10 posterior ribs is visualized above the diaphragm. The ribs and thoracic cage are seen only faintly over the heart. Okay, so we are going to visualize or detect any abnormality like pneumothorax or pleural effusion. So the ribs of thoracic cage are seen only faintly over the heart. Clear vascular marking of the lungs should be visual for the vessel. Okay, practical points. In the context of inhaled foreign body, bilateral decubitus lateral view should be performed. Okay, allowing for adequate assessment of any air trapping. Okay, next one is patient with obstructive foreign body will not have a collapsed lung, however will manifest hyperlucency of the dependent lung. Okay, ensure the patient is carefully rested against the wall detector and at no risk of the falling. Okay, so patient should be in comfortable position. The rotation of our chest radiograph can stimulate common pathological process and make it hard to produce an appropriate diagnosis. Okay, the sternoclavicular joint, SC joint are a sound indicator for a positional rotation. If one sternoclavicular joint is noted wider than the other, that respected side needs to be rotated towards the image receptor to correct rotation. Okay, patients with a long standing history of emphysema or COPD will have abnormally long lungs compared to the general population. Remember this when collimating superior to inferior. Okay, side marker placement is imperative. Patient can have congenital condition that mimic a mirrored image. Okay, so remember to it is the most important point that explain to your patient what the procedure is. What the procedure is going by you. That is, ask them to take a breath and hold it. Many times that gives the patient time to prepare and result in a better recall and therefore a high quality radiograph. Always remember to tell the patient to breathe again, because some patients hold the breath and doesn't remember to breathe again. So always it is a responsibility of radiographic or technologist. Okay, I think you all you all. That is all with this session. Thank you. In the previous session, we had discussed about the first executive view. In this session, we are going to discuss about the wrist carpal tunnel view. What is the carpal tunnel view? Why it is used? Carpal tunnel view is an axial projection to demonstrate the medial and lateral prominences and the concavity. Okay. Indication. This carpal tunnel view is performed, however, it can be utilized to investigate the potential hook of hamate, tissue form and trapezium fracture. Okay. The positioning of patient. Patient stand with the back facing the table. Facing the table. Okay. Facing the table means projection is P. Okay. Palmar surface of hand is placed in contact with the facet. Okay. Which is placed at the table 1. Wrist is dorsiflexion approximately 135 degrees. Making the carpal and the metacarpal lift away from the head. Okay, next one is the technical factor. Technical factor, it is the axial projection. The central point is mid-carpal region. The central ray is vertical and will be centered to the midpoint of the torsion flexion. Okay, collimation. Laterally, it includes the skin margin, dorsal to the skin margin, ventral to the carpo. Metacarpal joints. Orientation. The orientation of cassette should portray detector size that is used is 8x10 inches or 18x24 centimeter. Exposure. Exposure that is used in the wrist joint or carpal tunnel view. The factor is 44 to 50 kV and the MEA should be 2 to 6 mA. Okay. SID. Post image separation should use 100 cm grid, no grid used because less radiation exposure factors are used. Image technical evaluation, there should be a clear outline of the ventral aspect of the carpal bone with no superimposition. Or this is a very specialized and slightly outdated position, yet it is not important or it is not performed. Okay? Okay, it is in projection and sitting down. We can take up image after seated the patient in dorsiflexion or after in the supine position, in the seated sitting position or supine position. Okay, so this is the carpal tunnel view. Next is the scaphoid view, PA scaphoid view. It is a part of the four view series of the scaphoid. Wrist and the surrounding carpal bone perform PA view. PA view can often be referred to as EP view. Indication. This view aims to show the scaphoid in its anatomical position, hence allowing the visualization of initiatable subtle distal, middle and proximal fractures. Patient position. Patient is seated alongside the table. The affected arm, if possible, is flexed at 90 degrees. So the arm and the wrist can rest on the table. The affected hand is placed palm down on the image receptor with hand in ulnar deviation. In ulnar deviation means it is a radius versus the ulna. So ulnar deviation. Okay, this is the ulnar deviation. Ulnar deviation. Okay. Shoulder, elbow, and wrist should all be in the transverse plane perpendicular to the central axis. The wrist and elbow should be at shoulder height, which makes the radius and ulna parallel. Okay. Technical factor or exposure factor. It is a PA projection, centering point anatomically central as like any other view of wrist, PA view. Okay. Collimation laterally. The skin margin, distal to the midway up to margin, metacarpal, proximal to the include one quarter, means one quarter, 1/4 of the radius and ulna. Orientation should portray detector size that is used is 8 by 10 inches or 18 by 24 centimeter. Exposure height is used is 44 to 50 kV and MA should be in the 3 to 8. Okay, SID. SID that is used is 100 cm grid, no width grid. Okay, image technical evaluation. Hand is in alert deviation with little superimposition over the scaphoid bone, minor superimposition of the metacarpal bone. Articulation between the distal radiation and ulna is open or has little superimposition, concavity of the metacarpal shaft is equal. Okay. So this is in this session we had discussed about the carpal tunnel view. This is a specialized in this specific view. Okay. To see the fracture of the hooks in the PC form or PC form repeating. Okay. और आफ्टर दैट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द स्केफोइड रिव्यू दैट इज इन रेडियो अल्ना प्रोजेक्शन. ओके थैंक यू सेशन इज ओवर. ओके थैंक यू द सेशन इज ओवर. आई थिंक दिस सेशन इज वेरी मच यूजफुल फॉर यू और वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर यू. आई थिंक यू आर सेटिस्फाइड विद दिस सेशन. If you have any queries, then put it into the comment box. I will resolve it later. Thank you. This session is over. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jayati Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur.